Hello and welcome back to Tesla News. My name is Marian and I'm your host today. Today we have lots of news to cover, guys. At the end of the video, we will dive into the Cyberlander, a product that is connected to the Cybertruck. We will look into the FSD update that hopefully, and I'm really saying hopefully, will come in 2 weeks. So we will look into that and the impact if that really happens. We have news coming from Giga Berlin in Germany. We'll look into footages from Tobias Lind shortly, and I will explain you what's happening over there. It's actually some good news. Then we have numbers from March in Europe when it comes to the EVs. So really good news here for Tesla as well. And we will look into the Chinese numbers that will be insane in April. I tell you that. I don't like to use that insane word anymore. I would say incredible, and yeah, they will be incredible, and I'm really looking forward for the numbers from China. So first of all, just as a reminder, these are the numbers from March in China: 25,000 Model 3s and right above 10,000 Model Ys. Looking at these amount of cars out here, it is pretty clear they are not only for the Chinese mainland market, but they are also for export. And we do see that, especially at the beginning of the quarter, that a lot of cars are made for export. The few cars that you see in front that are going to be driven away here on the trucks, these are mostly the cars coming for the mainland China market. So when we look at the European numbers, we have seen that Model 3 is really leading in a lot of countries and is really picking up its game. And the reason for that is that Giga Shanghai is exporting to Europe and helps to increase the numbers of sales in European countries. And when we look at the number of cars out there, it is just incredible to see how fast this factory is exporting and, yeah, growing. It's incredible to see. So what this means is, I do believe that for the month of April, we might see a new record number here for the mainland China market. I think it might be something around 40,000, 45,000. If in this quarter they fully concentrate on exporting at the beginning of the quarter, then it might be that we see a little dip in the numbers for the mainland China. So we might see a little dip in April, but then again a record in May and June. It really depends how Tesla is working that out here at Giga Shanghai. But what is really, really clear, guys, is the number of cars you see out there never happened. And I follow this factory since the beginning, and I must honestly admit, I have never imagined it will go that fast. When they did this entire parking lot recently, they expanded the parking lot, made it free. I was like, well, it is an empty parking lot. And the parking lot was empty 2.5-3 weeks ago. And we have constantly seen an increased amount of cars over there. So this is a really, really good sign, guys. Again, I believe we will see record numbers coming from Giga Shanghai very soon. And as well, this will impact the goal to reach 1 million cars this year. As I mentioned in my video yesterday, Loop Ventures mentioned the Model Y will be the key here to reaching 1 million cars. And I mean, honestly, if you look at that, I think it is possible. I think the role of the Giga Shanghai is really important to achieve the 1 million cars this year. And we will look into Giga Berlin in a second. We do know that there are delays, but again, I hope in Q4 we will see the first cars moving out. Looking at the numbers in Europe, I mean, it's just astonishing. We have 24,184,000 cars for the Model 3. And just to tell you, all VW products combined are achieving 18,000 and a few. So you see, even all the cars combined in March from all the products that VW has in the electric market, they are not reaching the Model 3, despite VW producing cars in Europe and Tesla just exporting to Europe, just as a reminder. Again, we do have here Giga Berlin, thanks to Tobias Lind, and there is actually some good news. There was a lot of talk about the water usage because there is not enough water in the region, and the water companies or the state-owned authorities that are taking care of the water usage over there, they have said Tesla can use 1.5 million cubic meter of water. And Tesla said they will need more. But it seems like they're coming to a deal here right now that Tesla is really trying to cut down the water usage and that they will try to use much less water for the battery cell production because they can reuse the water. So I think they kind of get along now, finally. They will kind of make some deals so they don't have to use more water. Because this is a big thing here in Germany. A lot of people talk about that water usage in an area where it is actually pretty dry already. And there's a lot of media coverage about that, that Tesla has to take care of the environmental issues. And this is one of the issues. Again, it's not Tesla's fault that they offered Giga Berlin in this area, but it is nice to see that Tesla is trying to solve the issue with the German authorities in this area. Looking at the FSD, guys, we do have more updates. Elon said, like, latest in 2 weeks, we will see the FSD. Again, I personally will admit that it is kind of a recurring situation that we do see more and more tweets, and it's not coming. And it's one of these situations where I honestly must admit, if they don't manage to do that till June, it might have a bad impact on the Tesla stock, because many people have invested into the stock because they know that the FSD, full self-driving, will come at some point. And if Tesla is delaying that, the FSD has nothing to do with battery constraint or any kind of issues with battery. This is just pure technology. And so that means Tesla is working on it, and it's good to know that they are really trying to solve the last issues. But again, the pressure might get higher and higher. When is finally this update coming, especially as people bought as well the FSD for a lot of money, and it is currently around $10,000, so it is not a small amount of petty cash that you just put on the table. So people want to use it, and this is the issue why more and more pressure will come. Again, I'm really excited. I think when the new FSD with Pure Vision will actually be updated in the cars for the beta users, and we will see the first people using it, I think we will see an increase in the stock. Again, that's my personal opinion here, because I do expect when people see real life usage of it, it will really blow a lot of people's mind. Looking at the Cyberlander, guys, it's a nice product here, but we do see a lot of sold out. So the Cyberlander is a product where you can connect that with your Cybertruck. And we do see that, especially for the Cybertruck model, that there is a lot of things that you can do with this Cybertruck. And this company specialized on doing kind of like the camping style version, or like you see now in the video here, using a lot of stuff to make your Cybertruck even more, even better. Again, they have now reservations for $50 million. And this is based on the average price we have here on the website of them. It's around 1,250 orders. The interesting part, what I think is, it is based on the total reservations, which might be a bit lower, around, let's say, 600,000. There's still a lot of potential to increase the revenue, but we do see that there is a need for such products, and people are willing to buy that. I mean, if you take the Cyberlander cost and you take the Cybertruck cost, you are at around $80,000. I mean, this is not cheap, guys.